Visiting Brussels is quite impossible no tasting very good beers. Abbey beers, Trappist beer, but most of all the typical beers of Brussels, the Lambic, the Goose and the Craig. And the best place where tasting, discover and appreciate these very unusual beers is the last active Lambic brewery in Brussels, the Brasserie Cantillon. And in the Brasserie Cantillon, we are going to make a virtual tour to discover how Lambic beer is produced.
Welcome at the Brewery Cantillon, the last active Lambic brewery in Brussels. This brewery itself was founded in 1900. Now, the recipe we use here is at least 4,000 years old. It has been discovered in Mesopotamia, the Middle East. What you see here is the brewing tank, and here everything will start. For one brewing, we need 450 kilos of wheat and 850 kilos of malted barley. Now, we start with adding something like 6,000 liters of this warm water, and then we put into action this blending machine, which will blend the water and the cereals for between 3 and 4 hours. After those 3 hours, 3 to 4 hours, you obtain a liquid which is called wort, W-O-R-T, which has nothing to say with beer yet, it's just sugary water. Now, this sugary water has to be extracted, this wort has to be extracted, and that's why we place those metal plates on the bottom of this cup. These plates are going to serve as a filter. Afterwards, we add another 4,000 liters of water, but the second time we don't have to put into action the blending machine anymore because the cereals will already be soaked, so the sugar will come out more easily. Once we extracted all 10,000 liters of wort from this tub, we are left with 1,300 kilos of wet cereals called draft, and drafts will be used to feed cattle on. This is where we pumped the 10,000 liters of wort in, and these are our two boiling kettles. Now, we need to boil over here for three different reasons. The first reason is the alcohol percentage. We added 10,000 liters of water to extract the most sugar possible from those cereals. Unfortunately, if we leave those 10,000 liters fermented, we'll only get an alcohol percentage between 3.8 and 4.2%. During the boiling, steam will be produced. Steam will be lighter than sugar. The steam will leave the kettles. The sugar stays in. We will lose 1/4 of all the liquid we added, so 2,500 liters of water will evaporate. With the 7,500 liters that we left with afterwards, we'll get an alcohol percentage of approximately 5% for all our beers. Second reason why we have to boil is to disinfect this liquid. And the third reason why we're going to boil is because we're going to add hops. So normally brewers add hops to give beer a bitter flavor. We will add hops to conserve the beer. We use hops that have dried for 3 years, have lost all their flavor, and we just add them to conserve the beer. And once those hop flowers have boiled with our liquid, you can easily conserve this beer for 10, 20, 30, 40 years without any problem. Well, this beer, once it gets into the bottle, it's still alive. It continues to fermentate, just like with wine, where an industrial beer, they're going to pasteurize it, they're going to kill all the yeast. After boiling for between 4 and 6 hours, we let the liquid to the second floor, where it will cool down during night. So this is our cooling tank. As you can see, this is a large surface, but only 55 centimeters deep. And its height is very important because this liquid gets up here at a temperature between 95 and 100 degrees Celsius, so almost boiling, and has to cool down in one night to something like 20 degrees. And that's the first reason why you can only brew during the winter months. If you would do such a thing in the summer months, in the morning you would still have a liquid of 50, 60, 70 degrees, which is too hot. You can't pump such liquids to wooden barrels. So during the winter months, once we have temperatures beneath 5 degrees Celsius, the bacteria will be killed, but the wild yeast can survive at such temperatures. So now we need to add them to the beer. And how will we do this? Well, it's quite easy. As you have seen, this tank is completely open, so those wild yeast are available in the air. And due to the contact of the air with this liquid, you get a contamination. And that's the specialty of this brewery, because none other brewery will use wild yeast to work with. There are only 5 of them that still do this, but most breweries want to control everything. The problem with wild yeast is that you can't control it. So here we have one of our three barrel rooms, and here we'll start to fill our wooden barrels. Why do you need wooden barrels? Well, you have this second fermentation in a barrel, and your beer will produce some carbonic gas. If you use metal barrels, they would just explode. During those 18 months, those wild yeast will continue to transform the sugar into alcohol and carbonic gas, but just like with wine, all the carbonic gas will leave through the pores of the wood. So lambic as such is a completely flat beer. On view, it resembles a little to apple juice. So this is our bottling machine. If you want to see, you can see some bottles over here. Our beers are always drank at cellar temperature, because the colder you drink something, the less you will taste. So normally you drink our beers between 8 and 15 degrees Celsius. Now what you see here is all what we have. So you have seen our barrel rooms. We have three of those barrel rooms, and this is our only cellar, and this is the whole production that we will have. So we can't produce more than those 120,000 liters that I spoke of before.